Hi guys, I'm Carl from Carl Ceramics and welcome back to one of my last Christmas themed videos. In this video I will be showing you how to make a reindeer cup. I will be starting off with throwing the cup and later on in the video I will be showing you how to decorate it as a reindeer. So without any further ado, let's just head over to the wheel and start off with throwing the cup. I start off with throwing the cup. I'll keep this short because you might already know how to do this. I start off with centering the clay. Then I open it up by pushing my middle finger into the middle of the clay and I pull the clay outwards. Then I start putting up the walls. I hold a sponge in my right hand and push towards my left hand on the inside, while making an upwards movement. I repeat this multiple times to make the clay thinner and the cup higher. Then I give the cup a bit of a round shape by pushing from the inside outwards, while softly holding a sponge on the outside. You can of course make the cup in any shape that you'd like. I go over the inside with a sponge to get rid of water and slip. Then I use this little piece of plastic to smooth out the rim. I bend it and hold it on top of the rim. This makes it nice and round and prevents a sharp edge. This does make some lines of slip. I easily get rid of these by going over it with a sponge. Then I get rid of some excess clay at the bottom of the cup by cutting it away with a wooden knife. After the cup has dried for a day and it is leather hard, it is time to trim. I trim off some clay at the bottom to make it flat and smooth. Then I trim away some more excess clay at the sides, so that the cup becomes a bit more round. And I also take away some clay at the bottom to make a foot. Then I go over it with a sponge. And I get rid of the slip by going over it with this trimming tool. This helps to smooth out the cup. And then I go over it with my fingers to smooth it out even more. I also like to smooth out the side of the cup a bit more, so I use these smaller hands from the Give and Grip. And I trim a little at the sides and I smooth it out in the same way as with the bottom. Then I start making the reindeer. I start off with the nose. I grab some clay and roll this in between my hands. Then I flatten it on top of the table. I just keep pushing on top of it and making it flatter and try to keep the shape symmetrical. I like to make a big nose which I will be glazing red later on. Then the nose is finished and I start off with making the eyes. I grab some clay and roll it in between my hands again. I grabbed a bit too much clay so I cut some off and rolled it again. I made sure that it was a nice oval shape. And then I cut it in half with a little knife. This makes it easy to make the eyes the same size. Here's a bit of a closer look. Unfortunately, my phone didn't fully focus on my hand, so I'm sorry about that. I smooth out the edges and flatten the eyes a little. Then I make the ears. I grab some clay and roll it in between my hands. I hold my hands tilted. This way the clay will become thinner at one side and this will already start to get the shape of an ear. Then I flatten it. And I cut it in half again. The back of the ears might not be very smooth, but this isn't a problem because this part will be attached to the cup. I mold the ears into a form that I like. I cut off some clay at the bottom of the ears. This side will be pushed onto the cup. Then I make some texture on the ears by pushing onto the middle part. As you can see, I make the ears at the same time. And I repeat the same things that I do. This is a much easier way to make them the same, instead of first making one ear and then the other one. Then I flatten the bottom part of the ears a bit more. And I make the top a bit sharper. And then I smooth them out with a sponge. Then the ears are finished and I start making the mouth. I take some clay and I roll it out very thin. I do this by just going over it with my hands on top of the table like this. Then I cut off a small part and I bend it. Cut off some more clay off the sides and then smooth out the edges. Then I start making the last parts of the reindeer, which are the antlers. These are quite difficult, but you can make the shape of them as difficult as you'd like. I roll out some clay again, I make it quite long and I try to keep the same thickness everywhere. Then I cut off a part. See if it is long enough to make the shape that I want and then I cut off the same size again. Just like the other parts, I will be making the two antlers at the same time. I bend them into this wavy shape that I like. And I cut off some smaller pieces that I will be attaching to the sides. You can make the antlers any shape that you want. Then I start attaching the different parts onto each other. I press onto the sides with this tool. I'm not using vinegar to attach these parts because the clay is still wet and the pieces have the same dryness. Then I smooth out the edges with the sponge. And I do the same thing on the other side of the antlers. I decided to make a pupil in the eyes. And then all of the parts are finished and it's time to attach them onto the cup. I start off by placing all the parts on top of the cup to see where I want to attach them. You can just move them around a little and see what you like. Then I grab my needle tool and I mark all the places where I want to attach the different parts. I do this with everything. The nose that I made was a bit too thick in my opinion, so I decided to flatten it a bit by pushing onto the table. And then I smoothed it out again. Then I used this scratching tool from Xeem Tools to scratch all of the parts that I just marked with the needle tool. And then I start attaching the pieces one by one. I apply some vinegar, scratch it again, and push the antler onto the cup. When I put pressure on the piece, I hold my left hand on the inside. And I apply the second antler the same way. Then I cut off some clay at the bottom of the antlers. I do this to make it look like the antlers are a part of the cup instead of just being attached onto it, if you know what I mean. I use this tool to make the shape more fluent, and I use a sponge to smooth it out. Then I start attaching the ear. I again apply vinegar, scratch it, and press the ear onto the cup. I attach the other ear and then I define the shape. I do the same thing as with the antlers. I cut off some clay and I shape the ears onto the cup, like this. And I smooth out the ears with a sponge. Then I apply the eyes. I apply vinegar to both of the spots at the same time, because it's important that the eyes are symmetrical, and attaching them at the same time will make this easier. Then I smooth out the edges with a vinegar brush, but you could also use a sponge. And then I attach the nose in the same way. Because I made the nose a bit bigger, the mouth needed to be attached at a different spot. I got rid of the scratches that I already made by going over it with a sponge. I decided where I wanted to attach the mouth. Marked this spot, scratched it with my needle tool, applied vinegar, scratched it again, pushed the mouth onto the cup, and used the vinegar brush to smooth it out. I bended the antlers a bit more forward and then the cup was ready to dry before biscuit fire. After it has been fired, I start glazing it. I made the nose red with underglaze from Emco. I used a small brush and applied it very carefully at the sides, so that it wouldn't get onto the cup itself. I applied 3 coats. This will make it an even color and you won't be able to see brush lines after the glaze fire. Then I used a black underglaze and a very small brush to color the pupils. When the underglaze is dry, I apply 2 coats of clear glaze onto the nose and the eyes. I let the glaze dry in between coats. I decided to glaze the rest of the cup with the glaze Albany Slip Brown from Emco. I had never used this glaze, so it was a bit of a risk, but that's a part of being a potter. I applied 3 coats all over the cup. I used a small brush to glaze around the eyes and the nose, and used a bigger brush to glaze the rest of the cup. I start with the face of the reindeer, then I glaze the inside and the top part of the cup. You have to let the glaze dry before applying the next coat. If you'd like, you can use a heat gun to dry it faster. Then I glaze the bottom part of the cup, and I brush on 2 more coats in the same way. I always get some glaze on the bottom of the cup. To prevent this from getting stuck onto the kiln shelf, I clean it by twisting it on top of this wet piece of fabric. And then the piece is finished and ready to be fired again. Here are some pictures of the final result. I love how the brown glaze turned out. That was it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked it and learned something new from it. If so, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so yet. And if you're going to make this reindeer cup yourself and you're going to post it on Instagram, please tag me at ColorCeramics so I can see your work. I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!